So huzn or sadness is a condition for the heart which is much more safer than being too happy. Of course, you must be careful that this sadness doesn't reach the level of depression. That is another issue. The difference is that when you are depressed, you do nothing. You become frightened to make any decision. You cannot do anything. But the sadness that I am saying is the sadness that makes you very active, the sadness that makes you determined not to lose any second of your life, the sadness that makes you look for a solution for your problems, for treatments for your illnesses. This type of sadness is very important. One of the characteristics of believers is that al-mu'minu bushruhu fi wajhih wa huznuhu fi qalbih. Mu'min is the one that when you look at his face, you find him happy. He smiles. You don't find that, you know, he has big problems. Because he doesn't want you to feel sad for him. He tries to socialize, he tries to make you, you know, relaxed. But وَحُزْنُهُ فِي قَلْبِهِ. But in his heart, he feels very sad. Therefore, when he is alone with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he starts crying. Imam Zain al-Abideen alayhi salam says in Dua Abu Hamza, he says, "Man yakunu aswa'a halan minni in ana nuqiltu ala mithli hali ila qabrin lam umahhidhu liraqdati wa lam afrushhu bil amal as-salih li taj'ati." He says, "Oh Allah, who is in a condition worse than my condition? If in such a condition that I have right now, I'm going to be put in my grave, a grave that I have not prepared for my stay, a grave that I have not furnished with amal salih, lam afresh hubil amal salih." When you want to go just for a weekend to a holiday, you make sure that you find a very good hotel. Does it have, you know, bathroom inside or not? Does it have Wi-Fi, you know, everything you check, breakfast, everything. What about a place that we are going to be there for thousands of years and then afterwards the Qiyamah, which has no end? So Imam says, if this is the condition, so why I shouldn't cry? What stops me crying over my condition? Mali la abki. So when mu'min has these serious concerns in his or her heart, when he or she sees that he always promises to Allah that I am going to be a good person, then he fails. Of course he feels sad. Of course she feels sad. But this is a sadness that doesn't stop you to be active. This is the sadness that doesn't make you depressed. This is the sadness that the Prophet had during the night. He was crying like a mother who has lost his child. But during the day, he was so active that he challenged all the emperors. When you are sad with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this gives you power. This is a sign of you being poor. But if someone is poor with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is rich with the people. Imam Hussain alayhi salam has a beautiful statement in Dua Arafah. He says, "Allahumma inni atawassalu ilayka bi faqri. I am doing tawassul, means I am looking for a means that can intercede, can be between me and you helping me. What is that mean? That means is my poverty. To admit that I am poor, I am needy, is the greatest thing that we can take with us to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Of course, this is in addition to your a'mal, this is in addition to tawassul to Quran, to tawassul to Ahlulbayt. But if you have all that without this, they are not going to work. If you feel that you are not in need of Allah's favor and Allah's mercy, you are not going to achieve anything. But then there is a challenge. After saying, I am doing tawassul with my poverty, atawassalu ilayka bifaqri, he says there is a challenge here. And he says, فَكَيْفَ أَتَوَسَّلُ إِلَيْكَ بِمَا هُوَ مُحَالٌ أَنْ يَصَلَ إِلَيْكَ. But how can I do tawassul to something that is impossible to reach you? Because poverty does not reach Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And poverty does not remain with the people who go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, sometimes you have an illness, you have pain. When you go to doctor, the pain or fever is not there. Then you don't know what to do. You say to doctor, I have no fever, but doctor checks there is no fever. I am taking my poverty with me to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but by the time I reach there, there is no poverty. Those who feel poor when they go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah make them the richest people. Those who feel sad because they feel that they are far from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah makes them the happiest people. وَجُوهٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ نَاظِرَةٌ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهَا نَاظِرَةٌ. Allah makes them so happy on the day of judgment that whoever looks at them realize these people are looking at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِلَىٰ رَبِّهَا نَاظِرَةٌ. So sadness, from a spiritual point of view, can be very healthy condition if it's not excessive, if it is not radical, if it doesn't go out of control, if it is for good reasons, if it is a sign of seriously thinking about your problems, if it's a sign of seriously regretting your sins and mistakes. This is very good.